Welcome, everyone, to Miss Biz's Guide to Furniture Crafting. Furniture crafting was introduced to Elder Scrolls Online in Update 13, which also brought us housing. So this update was called Homestead. Furniture crafting uses a lot of skills from all the current crafts in-game. So if you're not familiar with your basic crafts, such as blacksmithing, clothing, I have a whole playlist dedicated to explaining those crafts, and you'll probably want to check that out before you continue on this guide. If you already have a grip on crafting in Elder Scrolls Online, well, let's get down to the basics of furniture crafting. What are you going to need to actually learn how to make things? Well, you're going to need a whole bunch of different things. You are going to need designs, blueprints, diagrams, patterns, praxis, and formulas, which unfortunately I don't have one to show you, but that is what you're going to need. You're going to find these the same way you find provisioning recipes currently in game. So they are rarely going to drop from mobs. As well, you're going to be able to pickpocket them out of people's pockets. You'll be able to steal them out of furniture or maybe even find them in barrels. For furniture crafting, some new materials were also introduced into ESO. We have alchemical resin, bast, clean pelt, decorative wax, heartwood, mundane rune, and regulus. All of these are brand new materials as of update 13, and you will need these to craft furniture. None of the furniture recipes actually use all old materials. You're always going to need at least one of these new kind of materials. For which one? Well, I'm going to go into a little more detail, so let's get on to it. Like I already covered, all these different design plans, you're actually going to find like you currently find provisioning recipes. So your definite best spots for it is out of furniture, like desks and trunks and places like that. It's a pretty rare drop from mobs, but pickpocketing is also another really good way to get these. There's a reason some are called blueprints, some are called designs, some are called diagrams, etc. All right, so blueprints. Blueprints, anything you learn that is a blueprint, you're going to have to go to a woodworking station to craft it. As well, it's probably going to need the highest level of woodworking to craft it. For your designs, you're going to have to go to provisioning. So a cooking fire, that is where you're going to have to go once you learn this, you know, design. That's where you need to go to learn how to, to actually craft it. Diagrams are for blacksmithing. As you can see, things obviously come in different rarities. Patterns, you're going to want to go to a clothing station. Praxis, you need to go to an enchanting station. And formulae, you'll need to go to an alchemy station. Each new material actually correlates with one of the new types of design plans. So alchemical resin, you guessed it, this is for all those designs that you have to go to an alchemy station for. Bast and clean pelt is when you have to go to a clothing station. Bast is kind of like the clothing half, clean pelt is like the medium armor kind of half, except for furniture. Decorative wax, that is for making all your wax food at the provisioning station. Heartwood is for woodworking. Mundane rune is for anything you make at the enchanting station. And regulus is for anything that you make at the blacksmithing station. Where are you going to find these? Well, alchemical resin you actually find off of your alchemy resource nodes. Something I have noticed is that it only comes from like the plants, you know, columbine, wormwood, all those. Then you actually have a chance of harvesting alchemical resin. It does not seem to come from water skins or the gurgling bubble of, you know, water and rivers and whatnot. It only seems to come from the plants. Bast, this is whenever you are harvesting your clothing resource nodes. Clean pelt, this actually drops from mobs like leather does. So wherever you would, you know, kill a mob because it probably drops leather, they have a chance of dropping clean pelt as well. Decorative wax, you know how you clean out all those barrels and buckets and everything else as you're running through dungeons? Well, you're going to be starting to find decorative wax where you find provisioning supplies. Heartwood is obviously found when you are harvesting wood resource nodes. Mundane rune are found when harvesting enchanting rune nodes. And Regulus for when you are harvesting all those ore nodes. Something I have also noticed throughout my first week here of having this update on live is that the Plentiful Harvest Champion Point passive absolutely helps with finding the new resources. It's awesome. So normally you only have a rare chance of actually a resource node even dropping one of these new ingredients, but with Plentiful Harvest, I found more often than just once or twice, I was actually getting two of the new ingredients from one resource node. Unfortunately, currently in-game, all your survey reports that you get from crafting writs, you will not find any of the new ingredients when you harvest resource nodes from survey reports. Who knows, they might change this in the future, but currently, you do not actually get any of the new ingredients from survey reports or from your hirelings. You will notice that I said this is a mesh of all the different crafts. Here I have a high elf bench curved blueprint. Now this requires woodworking 2 to craft. When we say it requires woodworking 2, I don't mean that the number up here needs to be 2. This means that the first passive, you need to have at least 2 skill points into this passive. Well, it needs to be at 2 out of 10. That is what it means by level 2 woodworking. This number up here doesn't matter for that, for what I'm talking about. So as you can see, as long as I have woodworking 2 and all the materials, I am able to craft a high elf bench, curved. If you look up here though, even though this is a woodworking blueprint, you can see that this requires woodworking level 4 as well as tailoring, which is the clothing skill line, level 1. There is many things where, look at this, you need metalworking, tailoring, and woodworking at certain levels in order to craft one item. Here is where if you've been actually focusing one character on learning all of the crafts, it really starts to shine and help you out. Some people may have split up their equipment crafting from their consumable crafting, which before there was no reason not to. Well, that changes with furniture crafting. Now that we have this, you can see that some of these plans, like this furnishing diagram I have here, requires metalworking, which is blacksmithing and equipment craft, and it requires potency improvement too. That means it actually requires level 2 of potency improvement, which is enchanting, a consumable craft. So if you have all your crafts split up, you might want to focus on one character and get them all learned up. Now I'm actually going to take you through learning how to craft furniture. So as you can see, I have been saving up all of these different types of design plans that I've been getting throughout the week. So now I'm going to go ahead and learn a couple. I know I really like the high elf stuff, so I'm making sure I learn those. And we happen to be staying right beside a woodworking station, so that's why I just learned a couple of blueprints. So you're just going to go up to your woodworking station, and you'll notice up top that you have a new tab just for blueprints. This is where you go for all of your furniture crafting. So we can take a look and see what I have learned. Oh, look at that. I am lacking a shelf above my fireplace at home. So this might be what we have. You can see you have this little preview icon. Not very good. As well, you can actually see how much of an item you have, and the bottom number is how much you need to craft this item. You'll notice it uses heartwood, that new material, it uses the high elf style stone, and it uses pitch, which is an upgrade material for woodworking. You'll notice that furniture crafting actually uses a lot more resources. Normally, to craft a piece of armor or weapon, you need 1 style stone. This particular shelf needs 5. As well, you're going to find a use for all those green and blue upgrade materials that you probably have a lot of by now. So back to this little icon. Everybody knows the little icon isn't so awesome, and this is furniture. I'm using a lot of my materials. I want to know what I'm crafting. Elder Scrolls Online has added an actual preview window. Look at this. I can rotate the item. I can get a good look at the item I am about to craft. What's even better is once you are inside this preview window, you can actually just switch between all the different things that you've learned for that craft and just take a look and say, hey, maybe I want to build a bed. No, maybe I want to build a shelf and take a look. And of course, your ingredients are going to update along with it. Here, you can craft the item right from the preview window, or you can come back here and craft it from here, which is what I'm going to do. We're going to get ourselves a high elf shelf. Long. There we go. I have created a high elf shelf. And as you can see here, in your tabs, this is an add-on for the second row of tabs, but the top tabs are in the base game. There is a tab for furnishings. All of your furniture is part of your inventory. No, it does not go in your crafting bag. So when you're out going to craft furniture, make sure you don't craft too much because you still need to haul this all back home. Well, everyone, that was my quick guide on your basics to furniture crafting. I'm pretty sure I covered everything you need to know, but if you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment below. I will try to answer it as quick as I can. And if you enjoyed the video or if it helped you out, be sure to hit that like button. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.